In October 1997, the Cassini spacecraft launched on a voyage to the second largest planet in our solar system, Saturn. It arrived in 2004 and immediately began sending back a steady stream of images and data collected from 12 instruments, all designed to look at the planet in a variety of wavelengths. It even carried a probe, named Huygens after the astronomer Christian Huygens, who discovered Titan, Saturn's largest moon. The probe was equipped with 6 instruments to study the moon in detail. It landed on Titan's surface on January 14, 2005, and returned spectacular results. Meanwhile, the other instruments aboard Cassini continued their scrutiny, peering into every possible niche of Saturn as it circled. Among the scores of images taken by Cassini, this one, taken when the spacecraft drifted into the shadow of the giant planet, shielding it from the sun. This is the compilation of 165 images taken by the wide-field camera during a period of nearly 3 hours on September 15th, 2006. By digitally compositing ultraviolet, infrared, and clear filter images, and then adjusting the final image to resemble natural color, astronomers stitched together this ethereal image from the vantage of the cold darkness of Saturn's shadow. From this unique perch, some 2.2 million kilometers above the planet, Cassini was able to view it in a way never seen before. The microscopic particles that comprise the rings of Saturn flare into brilliance, the backdrop of bright sunlight causing them to sparkle like dew on wet leaves. Hidden ring structures containing these particles brighten substantially, revealing detail never before seen. The narrowly confined G-ring is easily seen here, just outside the bright main rings. And encircling the entire system is the much more extended E-ring, the icy plumes of Enceladus, whose eruptions supply the E-ring particles, betray the moon's position on the E-ring's left side. For the 12 hours that the Cassini spacecraft drifted in the shadow of this titanic planet, humanity was given a view impossible to obtain from Earth. We rely on our space probes, telescopes, and rovers to go places we have not, and they provide us with sights of the heavens we cannot see with our own eyes from the vantage point of our tiny stage on Earth. We launch our explorers from our tiny grain of sand on the shores of the cosmic ocean and travel sometimes billions of kilometers to return vistas that provide perspective and give us unprecedented insight. They travel out there saying, "Here is what the universe looks like." But sometimes they also provide a look from the other side, showing us what we look like to the universe. I love time.